गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे आई पूर्णिमा इज गोइंग टू टीच यू ए न्यू लेसन. द नेम ऑफ द लेसन विद इन. दिस लेसन इज रिटन बाय HPS आलूवालिया. ही वॉज द मेजर इन आर्मी इन 1965. नाउ ही हैज़ रीच्ड, ही वॉज इन ए टीम विच रीच्ड विच कॉन्कर्ड द हाइएस्ट पीक ऑफ हिमालय इन 1965. And he has shared his experience here in this lesson. So this is based on true story and the experience of a person, how he felt happy that he had conquered the summit. So now I am going to tell you about the background of the lesson, and I will tell you about the writer of the lesson, and then the explanation will be done. So now I start. So the name of the lesson is The Summit Within, and let me tell you, this lesson is written by Major HPS Ahluwalia. Now Major Ahluwalia, he was a member of the first team conquering Mount Everest in 1965, and in this extract he tell us about his feeling standing on the highest peak of the world, how he felt. He shared his feeling with all of us. Now I'm going to tell you about the background of the lesson. Major Ahluwalia was a member of the first team conquering Mount Everest in 1965. In this extract he tells about his feeling standing on the highest peak of the world. His first feeling was of humility. He thanked God because the expedition had ended successfully. He was both happy and sad. He felt aggrieved because he had reached the summit, and after that there would be nothing higher to climb. So see, he was happy also, but at the same time he was not satisfied that after reaching that highest peak of the world, he would be having nothing higher to climb. And climbing Mount Everest gives a deep sense of joy which lasts for lifetime. Now he was so happy, and he keeps on sharing his experience to many people here, and he had written this lesson also. The experiences changed one completely. Now he's telling, after that experience I was changed completely. It was a conquest of a high mountain, but the writer felt that climbing or getting over the summit of the mind was no less difficult. So he had told that it's very good, it's very a nice feeling was there when he climbed the summit, but at the same time he was very sad that he doesn't have to climb nothing higher than the Mount Everest. Now climbing Mount Everest gives us a deep sense of joy which lasts for a lifetime. Of course he was very happy through all his life. He was having a deep sense of joy that he had climbed the summit. The experiences changed once completely. He also shared that he was changed completely. How he changed completely? Anybody can tell me? Yes, the person gains more confidence. The person have a desire to do a thing of the higher level. So these were the changes in him. It was a conquest of a high mountain, but the writer felt that climbing or getting over the summit of the mind was no less difficult. While climbing down from the top, he asked himself why he had chosen to climb. The achievement became a thing of the past. It would fade with the passing of time. He questioned himself as to why people wish to climb high mountain. Now children, he was thinking that with the passing of the time, it would become a thing of past himself, and he would be very sad. It would fade with the passing of time, the experience, the joy. So he is questioning himself as to why people wish to climb high mountains. The simplest answer is that it is a difficult task. The man feels great in overcoming difficulties. Climbing a mountain was a tough task because it tests one's physical strength and willpower. So he is telling that it was his physical test of physical strength. It was a test of his willpower because it is not easy to task a high mountains. It is very difficult task for a man to climb high, and that's why it becomes a part of his memory, all these challenges he has to face while climbing. See how nicely he is sharing all this thing. When I will explain the chapter, you will realize. And then the writer, then the major, then proceed to answer the personal question. Mountain had an attraction for him since his childhood. Now children, he is sharing one of his very personal question, that when he was a child, then only the mountain used to attract him. He missed them while he was away from them. Their beauty and grandeur presented a challenge. Above all, mountains are a way to feel close to God. Now, he missed them while he was away from them. Their beauty and grandeur presented a challenge to him. Above all, mountains are a way to feel close to God. Now, children, he also told this thing, even he felt when he climbed the summit of the mountain, the Himalayan mountain, he felt as if he is close to God. But why Everest? He chose it because it was the highest and the most challenging task. Now, children, he is telling why only people generally choose to climb the Everest. So it was not only the highest mountain and the most challenging, it was the most challenging task also. It was a hard struggle with rocks and ice. When he stood on the summit, he felt the joy of having done something great. He also felt the joy of achieving a great victory. The call of Everest draws him to it. It is difficult to tell the reason for climbing. It is like answering why one satisfied. It is a proof of man's love for adventure. The experience is not just physical, but spiritual also. I told you, when the man climbs on the summit, he felt that he is very near to God. His labor come and his labor is ended there, and a feeling of joy is there, and the feeling of victory is there in his mind. And when you feel, he's also telling, when you feel like going back, but something, if you, that these are the moments are spiritual, but make all you fear to go up. Breathing is very difficult, he told, in the mountain, the high, when the person climbs mountain, high mountains, and there are moments when you feel like going back. Now, sometimes people are so discouraged that they feel that they should go back. But something in you checks you from giving up. But then, if you want to go, something is there who is checking that don't give up. Try hard. When you feel like going back, but something in you checks you from giving up. When you reach the top, you tell yourself that it was a rewarding effort. Now, children, the happiness is felt, is sharing that when we reach at the top, then we get the rewarding effect. And from there, if you will feel the vast valleys of the mountain, vast valleys of the Himalaya, you bow down to God for your worship. You will definitely thank to God that how hard labor you have done to climb over the summit, and a beautiful view it can be seen of the valleys of the high mountains. The writer left a picture of Guru Nanak and his companion. Rawat left a picture of Goddess Durga on Everest. Now, children, both, it seems to me that they were both very religious minded person, and they want to thank God for this. And what they have done, the writer, since he was Punjabi fellow, so he left a picture of Guru Nanak, and his companion Rawat left a picture of Goddess Durga on Mount Everest. Fu Dorji left a relic of the Buddha. Now, Fu Dorji was also there. I think his name, I think many people must have heard him. He was also in the first team which conquered Mountain Everest. So he left a relic of Buddha. Edmund Hillary buried a cross under the rocks in the snow. And I think you must have heard about Edmund Hillary also. He was the first man to go to reach the summit. So what he had done? He had buried a cross under the rocks in the snow. These are symbols of respect to God. Now children, they are paying their respect. They are saying they are thankful to God in this manner what they have done. This and the summit to climb, it is within yourself, your mind. Now children, how nicely this line is written by the writer. He is telling there is one and the summit to climb, and it is within yourself, and that is your own mind. The most difficult task is to know oneself. One has to do it alone and himself. The writer's experience as an Everester inspired him to face his life boldly. So he faced his life very boldly, in a very jubilant manner, because he got success and he was very happy. And he had described it in this lesson. He will be telling you about the panorama. Panorama is the view of the wide area. So now I have told you about the background of the chapter, and now I will be explaining you the lesson. Now I am going to read. Major H.P.S. Ahluwalia was a member of the first successful Indian expedition to Mount Everest in 1965. So you can see the name of the writer is also written here, Major H.P.S. Ahluwalia. He was a member of the first successful Indian expedition to Mount Everest in 1965. How did he feel when he stood on the highest point in the world? Let us hear his story in his words. Climbing the summit, and then the more difficult task of climbing the summit within. Now children, he has stressed on two things. One, the climbing of the summit of the Mount Everest, and one, the climbing of the summit of within yourself. That means you will get success if you will mind your soul, if you will mind yourself, if you will do the hard labor, if the sweat will come from your body, then only you will get success in your life. And for that you have to climb the summit which is within there you. Now I'm going to read the first paragraph. Of all the emotion which surged through me as I stood on the summit of Everest, looking over miles of panorama below us, the dominant one, I think, was humility. The physical in me seemed to say, thanks God, it's all over. However, instead of being jubilant, there was a tinge of sadness. Was it because I had already done the ultimate in climbing and there would be nothing higher to climb, and all road hereafter would lay down? So he is telling, of all the emotion which surged through me. Surge means arose suddenly and intensely. So of all the emotion which surged through me as I stood on the summit of Everest. Now he had gone to the summit. He is standing on the summit of Mount Everest. Okay, summit means the topmost portion, the highest peak. Looking over miles of panorama below us. Now panorama, as I told you just a few minutes ago, panorama means view of a wide area. So he was enjoying the beautiful view of the wide area while he was over miles he was looking the panorama below us. The dominant one, I think, was humility. And the dominant is the main panorama was he experienced was of humbleness. Humility means humble. The physical in me seemed to say, children, why in the most important view he had of humbleness. First of all, humbleness, many people think that why humbleness is the view should be something very external. Humbleness is related with your internal soul. So he is telling, of course he is telling, children, I told you earlier also that he climbing the summit, that means he is telling, one, he had climbed the Mount Everest, and the other is the summit which we have to control ourselves. So he is talking of that summit. Now the physical in me seemed to say, thank God it's all over. And children, from inside his soul he is being very humble to God. He is telling you, with your grace everything is over. And he got a success also, he has climbed over the summit. Was it because I had already done the ultimate in climbing and there would be nothing higher to climb and all roads hereafter would let down? Now, was it because I had already done the ultimate in climbing and there would be nothing higher to climb and all roads hereafter would lead down? Now, he is telling all roads will lead down, okay? And he is giving advice that first of all, whenever we get success, we should thank God like he had also done. And he was also feeling sad that from now there would be nothing higher to climb and all roads hereafter would lead down. Now children, after that no road will climb above. They have climbing the highest peak of the world. They have conquered the highest peak of the world. Now they don't have to climb higher. Now all the roads will go down. So he was feeling sad. Still he wanted to go to the higher place. By climbing the summit of Everest, you are overwhelmed by a deep sense of joy and thankfulness. Now he is sharing his experience. Okay. First, write the meaning of overwhelmed. Overwhelmed means filled with excitement. Overwhelmed means filled with excitement. So he is telling, first of all, I was very much thankful to God and a deep sense of joy overwhelmed me. Overwhelmed, as I told you, what is the meaning of overwhelmed? Filled with excitement. So I was so happy that he was filled with excitement. So it is a joy which lasts a lifetime. Now he is telling, it is a joy which I think he will last through lifetime. The experiences change you completely. Now he is telling that experience had changed me completely. Now what type of change you are feeling? Definitely he got success. So the result is that his confidence level was much higher. And when a man feels successful, he had a very nice feeling of joy. So this both things, so that's why he's telling, this experience changed me completely. He was full of a confidence level and he was very happy. He also thought that he is a strong and a healthy person. The man who has been to the mountains is never the same again. He is telling, the man who had already climbed the summit, that man is never same again. There is a lot of changes. He is gaining the confidence level. He is very happy. He is strong. He is healthy. So lot of things are there. As I look back at life after climbing Everest, I cannot help remarking about the other summit. The summit of the mind, no less formidable and no easier to climb. Now he is also telling children, simultaneously he is telling about two summits. One which he had climbed over the highest peak of the world, the Mount Everest. Now other summit he is telling about the summit which he should climb inside upon his soul. As I look back at life after climbing Everest, I cannot help remarking about the other summit, the summit of the mind. So children, you can see what he is telling. He is telling about the summit of the mind. no less formidable and no easier to climb. Formidable means difficult. Formidable means difficult. And he's telling it is the summit of the mind is also very difficult to climb, and it is not an easy thing to climb over the summit of the mind. You can see the picture of Major Ahluwalia. You can see how nicely, how smiling his face is full of confidence, as you can see. Even when getting down from the summit, once the physical exhaustion had gone, exhaust means tiredness. If a person feel very tired, that is exhaust. So he is telling ki when he came down from the summit, once the physical exhaustion had gone, now he was so tired that it took a lot of time to gain physical exhaustion. I began asking myself the question, why I had climbed Everest. Now children, he has started asking question, why I had climbed Everest. Why did the act of reaching the summit have such a hold on my imagination? It was already a thing of the past. Now children, now he is sharing some more thing. He is telling that it was the fear thing of past. That means from the very beginning he want to go, the mountain attracted him and he want to conquer that mountain. So when he was very small, then only this feeling had come. Something done yesterday, and though he had been long to the Everest, but he was feeling as if he had done this thing yesterday only. With every passing day it would become more remote. And then what would remain? Why would my memories fade slowly away? Now he's telling a daily after every passing day. After every passing day, he's telling thing is passing, fading away from my memory. So he's telling
अच्छा चला गया है मोहित से, कहो कि एक जल्दी से वो कर ले, एडिट करके ज़रा सा कर ले, उसको कहो उठ जाए। तो पहले एक एप्लीकेशन हम भेजते तो एक वो तैयार कर रहा था ना, कुछ करे नहीं, केवल ही करके लोग मेरा भी टाइम कल वेस्ट किए। बेटा मेरा काम नहीं बना, सर वेट कर रहे हैं,
अभी बना ही नहीं है। उससे कहो उठ के एडिटिंग कर ले, और हल्ला नहीं करेगा क्या देना है ना। अरे कुत्ते को चुप कराओ जरा सा प्लीज, उसको इधर लेकर आओ। मोहित, टॉमी को इधर लेकर, वीडियो खराब हो जाएगा एकदम। टाइम नहीं सर, वेट कर रहे हैं 9 बजे तक, और तुम तब तक से उसको वो जिसमें साउंड नहीं है ना सुन करके, थोड़ा हाफ एन आवर खिसका के सकते साउंड, जहाँ जहाँ नहीं उसको गैप को कम करो।
मम्मी वो मेरे पास आएगा तब तो कम करेंगे।
तो तुम रात में ये भी नहीं करे हो,
जब हम वी ट्रांसफर काम ही नहीं कर रहे तो हम,
हाँ वी ट्रांसफर नहीं काम कर रहा, अभी सर आए हैं
तो
बोले
कैसे अपने में
डायरेक्ट भेजना है। सर ने कहा कि अभी मैसेज आया कि वी ट्रांसफर से मत भेजे, किसी का नहीं हो रहा है। ओके तो वो ज्योति वाले में है, उससे डायरेक्ट भेजो। क्लास 12 का बोलना नहीं, हम वो कर रहे हैं।
एक सेकंड, तो डायरेक्ट भेज दें,
पहले अपने भेजोगे, हम वो करेंगे ना।
मम्मी जब मेरे में आ ही नहीं सकता,
वी ट्रांसफर के थ्रू नहीं भेजना है, डायरेक्ट भेजना है, मेल टू मेल। अभी देखो हर्षित से पूछो, चलो जल्दी करो, मेरे को डिस्टर्ब मत करो, टाइम नहीं है। हैं तुम लोगों ने जो आज तमाशा मचाया है, कुछ कहने की बात नहीं। Now he is telling, I have a more personal answer to the question from my childhood. I have been attracted by mountains. So once again I repeat this thing, that children, I have already told you that from the very beginning he had a very much attraction with the mountain, and he had written straight away here that he was not only attracted by the mountain, but when he used to move away from the mountain, he used to feel very miserable, lost, unhappy when he was away from the mountains in the plain area. and he is telling that was a part and parcel of my life. When he is to move, he is to feel very lost, very unhappy, very miserable. Mountains are nature at its best. Now he is telling mountains are the best part of the nature. Their beauty and majesty pose a great challenge. He is telling their beauty and majesty pose a great challenge. And like many, I believe that mountains are a means of communion with God. And I feel that he is the very religious minded person, because when in the beginning of the lesson also he told that first of all I must thank the Almighty. And he had put one photo of Guru Nanak on the summit. So he start the initial part of the lesson, he start like that only. And so he is sharing that I believe, it is his belief that mountains are a means of communion with God. Communion means a state of feeling of close relationship. Once having granted this, the question remains, why Everest? Because it is the highest, the mightiest, and has defied many previous attempts. Now he is telling that why this Mount Everest, one having granted this question remains, why Everest? Now he is telling that many people think that why Everest? Why not the other mountains? Because it is the most highest, the most mightiest, and many people had defied, that means many people had resisted many previous attempts, and they have become frustrated also. It takes the last ounce of one's energy, and he had given a lot of his personal experience that the person he feels that the last ounce of energy has been taken. It is a brutal struggle with rock and ice. Now it is a brutal struggle with rock and ice. Once taken up, cannot be given up halfway, even once life is at stake. Now he is telling that if one goes up at the mountains, he don't feel like coming, because climbing up is very difficult and climbing down is also very difficult. So people, even if they feel that life is at risk, then also they don't like to come back. They think that it is better to climb onwards. And then he also tells, when the summit is climbed, there is exhilaration. Exhilaration means very exciting and very the feeling of happiness is there in oneself. The joy of having done something. The sense of a battle fought and won. There is a feeling of victory and happiness. Glimpsing a peak in the distance, I get transported to another world. Now children, he is telling, glimpsing means when he was looking over a peak in the distance, he thought that he had gone to some another world. I experienced a change within myself also. Now children, he is telling something very personal, that he had also experienced a change within himself. Which can be called mystical. So children, this change he had felt, mystical means something very spiritual. By its beauty, aloofness, might, brightness, and the difficulties encountered on the way, the peak draws to me as Everest did. Now he is telling that he had felt that he had turned into a spiritual person, and by its aloofness, alone, the mountain standing alone, facing everything, might, power, ruggedness, that means the way was not very good, okay, very rough way was there when he was climbing, and the difficulties encountered on the way, the peaks draw me to it as Everest did. It is a challenge that it is difficult to resist. So he is telling it was a challenge to him. It is a challenge that it is difficult to resist. Looking back, I found that I have not yet fully explained why I claim Everest. Now children, again he feel, and he told me he want to share one thing more. He want to explain one thing more why he had climbed Everest. It is like answering a question, why you breathe. एंड चिल्ड्रन वाई यू क्लेम क्लाइम द माउंट एवरेस्ट इट इज़ जस्ट लाइक द क्वेश्चन दैट वाई यू ब्रीथ वाई डू यू हेल्प योर नेबर वाई डू यू वॉन्ट टू डू गुड एक्ट्स देर इज़ नो फाइनल आंसर पॉसिबली सो ही इज़ टेलिंग टिल नाउ आज दो मैनी रीजन ही आर शेयर्ड बट टिल नाउ ही डिड नॉट कैन टेल द फाइनल आंसर डेट वाई ही हैड क्लाइम ऑन एवरेस्ट द मैन हु हैज़ बीन टू माउंटेन टॉप बिकम्स कॉन्शियस इन ए स्पेशल मैनर ऑफ हिज ओन स्मॉलनेस इन दिस लार्ज यूनिवर्स सो चिल्ड्रन दिस ही हैज शेयर्ड विद अस एंड देन द रेस्ट ऑफ द पार्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू इन माई अदर वीडियो थैंक यू एंड हैव ए नाइस डे अहेड